Okay, but can we get into this new hair? Like, oh, I can do this now. Ready? Cue the intro. It's Brooklyn and I'm back once again with another YouTube video. So as you guys can tell from the title, I'm going to be doing another Bible study video titled Practice What You Preach. And child, I need this for myself. This is something that I need to work on too. I definitely felt like this was definitely needed for our brothers and sisters in Christ because it's needed, okay? It's just very beneficial. For those of you guys who are new, hi, my name is Brooklyn and I post faith-related content. I also sprinkle some stuff here and there. If you haven't checked out any of my other Bible study or faith-related videos, I have them up here for you guys to check out, so feel free to check those out for me. Before we go any further, do not forget to hit that subscribe button, like, comment, and also turn on those post notifications so that way you guys will not miss out on any uploads. Without further ado, let's get on started. At this point, y'all already know the drill. Got my notes here. So let's get in this thing. Okay, so the focus scripture that I chose for this Bible study is James 1 verses 22 through 25. And I'm just going to be reading from the New King James Version. So it says, "But be doers of the word and not hearers only, deceiving yourselves. For if anyone is a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like a man observing his natural face in a mirror. For he observes himself, goes away, and immediately forgets what kind of man he was. But he who looks into the perfect law of liberty and continues in it and is not a forgetful hearer but a doer of the work, this one will be blessed in what he does." So as I was reading that, I did take away a lot of things from it, and it's to not just hear the word but to actually live out and carry out what it says. First and foremost, none of us are perfect, and so as much as we try, we're never gonna reach God's standard. You know what I'm saying? We're always gonna fall short because as humans we sin and we fall short of the glory of God, and God knows that we're human. He knows we're gonna mess up and he knows that we're gonna make mistakes. Us as humans, we are entirely incapable of being perfect and being spotless. We're human, and sin unfortunately runs rampant in this world, and we all fall short of his standard. One thing that really stood out to me was the part where it says it's almost as if you look in the mirror and you forget about what you look like. That's like you reading the Bible, and listen, I'm guilty of this, so before I say anything else, I just want to say I am guilty of this, and I'm being humble and I'm being transparent with you guys. This is something that I'm still working on myself, and I'm definitely on the road of getting better at it, but I digress. So just like the mirror analogy, it's like you read the Bible and then you just say, okay, I'm done. Like, that's it. But you don't fully grasp or you don't fully register what the word is trying to tell you. As Christians, it's important that we're not just reading the Bible, but we're actually walking this thing out, living this thing out. It's one way to know Bible verses, but it's another way to actually carry out these verses that we read. So for example, when the Bible says to trust in God and lean not on your own understanding, it's like, okay, you can say that all you want, you can read it and you can go around telling people to trust in God, but are you actually relying on Jesus? Are you actually putting your faith and your trust in Jesus? Are you living out what you're telling people and what you're saying? And like I said, I'm still working on this area because I don't want to just say empty words. You know, when I'm praying to God or when I'm trying to communicate with God, I don't want to just say empty words. Listen, there have been times where, you know, you may struggle in believing what the word says. God can help us, and he can really help us to lean on his word and to believe and have faith and to walk this thing out. Do not be a hypocrite. Like, you can say love your neighbor, but if you're not really living this out, if you're not actually loving your neighbor, And what sense does that make? If you're going around telling people to forgive people or to not hold grudges, yet you're doing the opposite of what the Bible's telling you, you're not doing what the word says yourself. You see where that makes you look like a hypocrite? It's like the word says in Ephesians 4 to forgive others just as Christ forgave you. It's easier said than done. It's easier to tell people, forgive people, because God forgave you, but you actually have to live it out. You can't tell other people to do what God told you to do and you're not doing it your own self. That even goes to salvation. You can't just say, I believe in God, spread the gospel or preach the gospel to other people, yet you're not practicing what you preach. You're not living out and you're not carrying out what you're saying to other people, if that makes sense. I'm sorry, this is low-key all over the place, but y'all get where I'm coming from. Y'all get what I'm trying to say. Praise God. When reading the word, it's very important that we pray and we ask God to help us walk in it. And you know, sometimes there's times where you have unbelief in your heart, but all you got to do is ask God, Lord, help my unbelief. I've definitely been there, and I know so many people have been there at some point. God is willing to help you, and he's willing to be patient. I overthink a lot, and I tend to think, oh, this person probably is so tired of me. This person is probably irritated with me. They're not patient with me. They're getting annoyed. They're upset. And honestly, that kind of seeped into my own relationship with God. There's times where I felt like, oh, if I messed up, I feel like God is irritated with me, or because I'm falling short in a certain area. People may get irritated with you. People may not be patient with you, but Jesus is patient, and God and people are not the same at all. God is patient with you, and he's willing to help you. He's willing to help you carry out the word and what you tell other people. And also, just know you cannot do it on your own strength. It's impossible. You can't. I've tried it and I failed miserably. It's nothing but God that can help you. I know sometimes we feel like we can do it on our own strength and that we got this and we don't need nobody's help. First of all, that's prideful. Second of all, apart from God, you can't do anything. Even with little things like this, practicing what you preach, that is something that the Holy Spirit has to help you with. And the Holy Spirit can really help you with that. One example could be, say you go around telling people, oh, you shouldn't gossip. You are spreading the word of God and you're saying, oh, it's wrong to gossip. You shouldn't gossip. So you read the verse for yourself where it says to not use slander or to not gossip amongst other people. And then you completely just say, oh, okay, that's it. And then you still continue to gossip. You just read it, but you're not applying it. That can also be something that a lot of people struggle with too. And I speak for myself when I say this. It's one thing to know the word, but it's another thing to apply it. When you apply the word of God to your life, with the Holy Spirit's help, of course, that's when you can really see the fruit of what God is trying to do in your life. That's when you can see, okay, I'm being changed. I'm being renewed. God is doing something new in me, and I'm becoming a new creation in Christ. It is only through the Holy Spirit that we can live the word out, because the Holy Spirit is an advocate. Not only is he an advocate, but the Holy Spirit also has the power to convict us of certain things. When we know we're supposed to apply the word of God to our life, that's when the Holy Spirit can be like, hey, listen, you read this, right? I'm gonna need you to apply it to your life. You know what I'm saying? The Holy Spirit is a helper and he is also a guide. I think it's so important that we really take heed to what the Spirit of God is trying to tell us through his word, and to not just read it and then go about our business, but to actually like let it marinate in our spirit, register in our minds what God is trying to tell us. It's almost like studying for a test. If you just look at the information and just say, all right, I'm done, you're most likely gonna forget what it says. But if you sit and actually take the time to read your material and to understand and to really let it register, you're gonna retain the information a whole lot more. And then that's when you can carry it out on your test or on your exam or where have you. It's the same thing to the word of God. When you actually sit and allow God to speak to your heart, it's like, okay, God told me to do this. Father God, I pray that you will help me to live your word out. He will help you. Your actions will begin to change. As some people say, the Holy Spirit is the best teacher. And also something else I want to revisit. We must have faith in what God's word says. And a scripture that I actually found that I've known for some time now is Hebrews 11:6, where it says, without faith, it's impossible to please God, and that he rewards those who diligently seek him. That scripture really like started tugging at me as I was writing the notes for this Bible study, because we can't please God if we don't have faith, because that's almost like a slap in the face towards God. We say we have faith in God, but then we continue to doubt out. It's like it cancels out what you're telling God you believe. That's not pleasing God, because you can't please God without having faith in him. You have to have faith in what God's word says and ask God to help you believe in what his word says. It's way easier said than done. It's way easier said than done. And what a lot of people don't know is that faith plays a huge role in having a relationship with Christ. You know, your parents say they're going to do this for you. They're going to make a way for you. They're going to provide for you. It's the same thing with God. You have to have faith that he will have provisions for you. You have to have faith that he will care for you, because he's got you. And without faith, you can't please God. It's a process. It's not going to be an immediate thing, but as you continue to walk with God, he'll show you that you don't have anything to worry about because he's there. So before I sign off, I want to say a quick prayer real quick. So bow your heads and close your eyes. Dear Heavenly Father, I want to say thank you for your word. Thank you for allowing me to be a vessel for you. I pray, Father God, that you will get the glory out of all of this and that it's not about me, but it is about you. I thank you for every person that is watching this video. I thank you for giving me the opportunity to spread your word. Lord, forgive us of our sins. Forgive us for when we were unpleasing in your sight. Forgive us for not having faith. Forgive us for not believing in what your word says. I pray, Father God, that you will help our unbelief. Help us to have faith and to stand firm on what your word says. Help us, Father God, to practice what we preach. Help us to not forget about what you told us, but to actually let it sit and let it marinate in our spirits, so that way we can live it out, so that we can walk it out. Because it's one way to say, oh, I believe in God, or I believe in what you said. It's another thing to actually live it out and to actually walk it out. So I pray, Father God, that you will help us. Holy Spirit, have your way in our lives. Help us to live out what your word says, not just to give you lip service, but to actually walk this thing out. And it is in Jesus' name that I pray. Amen. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Like I said, do not forget to hit that subscribe button. Like I said before, feel free to check out my other faith-related videos somewhere up here. Also, don't forget to follow me on my socials, which are also up here and down below as usual. God bless you guys. I love y'all so much, and I will see you next time. Mwah, bye.